If you've ever wanted to check out glamorous jewelry seen only on Hollywood starlets, well, an upcoming costume jewelry convention show is sure to dazzle you. This morning, we're joined by Michelle and Tina Joseph of Joseph of Hollywood to talk about this upcoming event. Good morning to you both.
Good morning, Michaela.
So, Tina, first and foremost, you're here on the East Coast for a great convention. Tell us about it.
Well, it's the Costume Jewelry Collectors International. This is our third year participating, but it's women who and men who love costume jewelry, and they get together and share their new and favorite pieces and have a lovely gala one evening, and everyone gets dressed up in all of their finery, and
beautiful.
And we all compare and see who has the most beautiful jewelry.
Do you have to be a collector to go to this? Is it open to the public?
It's open to the public, yes.
But great opportunity then,
yes,
for someone to come away with it with a great piece. You're wearing one of them right there.
Well, you can't come away with this one.
No, but tell us about what you are wearing.
The piece I'm wearing was worn by Rita Hayworth. Down to Earth, and she also wore it in Gilda.
Great. Rita Hayworth, gosh, Marilyn Monroe, Elizabeth Taylor, I mean, the list goes on and on. And Michelle, tell us, who wore these stunning pieces on the table?
Well, I don't know which side to start with.
There's too many.
This one was worn in the movie Marie Antoinette with Norma Shearer. Okay. This one was designed for Lucille Ball for her personal wardrobe.
I love Lucille Ball.
She also wore this one in Annabelle Takes a Tour. Mm-hmm. This beautiful ruby one over here was Bette Davis. She wore it twice because she played Queen Elizabeth twice.
Okay.
And one was Private Lives of Elizabeth and Essex, and the other one, the Virgin Queen.
Mm-hmm.
This beautiful amethyst up here
looks familiar to a lot of
people.
Yes.
This one is from Gone with the Wind. Vivian Leigh wore this one.
Classic.
Then we have a few pieces down lower. Mm-hmm. We've got a Jean Harlow piece.
Look at that.
Beautiful, enlivened lady.
And I want to get to these masks too, because these are very unique.
We just made these for the convention. They're going to auction them off for charity.
Look.
Yes, each one is one of a kind.
This is wild. I love this.
And then a few other pieces quickly is the snake here. Cleopatra, Elizabeth Taylor.
Mm-hmm. And these are original pieces.
These are the actual pieces that were worn in the movies by the stars. And this pair of earrings out front here, Grace Kelly.
Wow. Tina, I think too, if you look up Joseph of Hollywood and you read the articles, the outside of your building is so deceiving, but when you walk in, it's full. Drawers, shelves, just packed with so much history.
Right. Well, we have a room that's just a vault, and that's all that's in the vault is just trays and trays of jewelry. And my father-in-law's concept was you make it and you rent it and you retain it, and therefore you can rent it again and again.
Oh my
and
gosh.
Again.
It's so,
so
packed.
At one time it was rumored we had about 1.5 million pieces.
Wow. Oh my gosh. And maybe one of these could be yours. Ladies, thank you so much for coming in and sharing all of these stunning pieces. If you want to check out the Costume Jewelry Convention, we'll post all the event details on our website. Just go to WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.